Good morning. Good morning. Welcome. Welcome, everybody. We are gathered here today. You may be seated, please. Yeah. We are gathered here today in St. Joseph's Church to pray for the happy repose of the soul of Mary McGrath and to ask our loving God to comfort her husband, Maurice, her daughters, Stephanie and Edel, and her son, Conor. Her brother, Seamus, his wife, Mary, and the whole family circle. I say hello to all who are tuned in to us via the webcam, especially Annie and the boys in Australia, Connor's two boys, Finian and Benny. We've all been touched and saddened by Mary's passing. It is tough for her family. I admire their courage and their strength and how they've stuck together this last while during Mary's serious illness. In times like this, it's natural for us to come together to pray, to show solidarity with those who mourn. We turn to God for comfort and strength, believing that God is a God of compassion and love and shares even in our pain and sadness. That was the God that Mary McGrath believed in and connected with. We know we don't have a lasting dwelling place here on this earth, and so we believe that this powerful God has, in his infinite love, provided an eternal home for us in heaven. This is our hope. Jesus Christ has promised that where he goes, he will bring us with him, to be with him. He is our friend and companion on the journey of life, and especially in times of sorrow. Mary McGrath, I will speak later, but Mary was such a well-loved person in this parish community, and it's only fitting that we all come here today to celebrate her life. She made a huge contribution to the cultural and social and spiritual life of this community. And so today we give thanks for her life and for her contribution. Please stand now. And we begin our Mass in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My sisters and brothers, we call to mind our sins and ask God for pardon and healing. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, Lord. As our faith in your Son raised from the dead is deepened, may our hope of resurrection for your departed servant Mary also find new strength. We pray through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Now let us listen to the Word of God. I invite the readers, please.
First reading, a reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is a season for everything, a time for every occupation under heaven, a time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted, a time for killing, a time for healing, a time for knocking down, a time for building, a time for tears, a time for laughter, a time for mourning, a time for dancing, a time for throwing stones away, a time for gathering them up, a time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing, a time for searching, a time for losing, a time for keeping, a time for throwing away, a time for tearing, a time for sowing, a time for keeping silent, a time for speaking, a time for loving, a time for hating, a time for war, a time for peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. We know that he who raised the Lord Jesus to life will raise us with Jesus in our turn and put us by his side and you with us. You see, all this is for your benefit, so that the more grace is multiplied among people, the more thanksgiving there will be to the glory of God. That is why there is no weakening on our part, and instead, though this outer man of ours may be falling into decay, the inner man is renewed day by day. Yes, the troubles which are soon over, though they weigh little, train us for the carrying of weight of eternal glory, which is out of all proportion to them. And so we have no eyes for things that are visible, but only for things that are invisible. For visible things last only for a time, and the invisible things are eternal. For we know that when the tent that we live in on earth is folded up, there is a house built by God for us, an everlasting home not made by human hands in the heavens. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me." The Gospel of the Lord. There's a time for everything. Strange how things happen in life. Things totally unpredictable, unforeseen. You might think accidental, but not quite, because there's always an element of mystery about life. One night in 1977, or perhaps 1978, a few people from Duhrach in this parish and from Dromore decided to go to an Irish music session in a public house in Petticoat. I can't give the name of the public house. I'm not allowed to advertise. That same night, a young man from Ederney in this parish also decided to go to the same Irish music session in the public house in Petticoat. And during that session, that young man struck up a conversation with a young woman from Dromore. He took her out to dance, even though he had two left feet. But a friendship began that night, which led to marriage 2 years later. The young man, aged about 20, was Maurice McGrath. And the young woman, aged also about 20, was Mary Melley. They became friends and got married in 1980. And the rest, as they say, is history. They made their home in the townland of Moneyvriece, brought 3 children into the world, enjoyed their life together, travelling all over Ireland, indeed all over the world, mostly to attend dancing sessions. One of the first things Mary tried to do was to teach Maurice to dance. Mary, as you all know, was a gentle and a caring person. A devoted wife to Maurice and a caring mother to Stephanie, Edel and Conor. She was born and reared in Dromore. Dromore had always a special place in her heart, but so too had Duhrach, her mother's native place. Her mother was Vera Maguire, and many of us knew her mother's brothers, Benny and Seamus, who were faithful members of this parish. Seamus was the quiet one. Benny was more outgoing. Both were great characters. Mary and her mother used to visit them often in Duhrach, especially after Mary's father died. When she was about 16, she learned to drive her father's car at that young age. And Mary and her mother and their uncles went to many music and dancing sessions. She had grown up in a traditional music house, always music in the Melley home. When Mary and Seamus were growing up, there was a gramophone there in those days and plenty of records. They all learned to play musical instruments. Mary learned the accordion with the master himself, Sean Nugent. And from an early age, she attended the Kerrigan School of Dancing in Omagh. And this thus began her great love for Irish dancing, ceilidh, the sets, and all kinds of dancing. She even became an adjudicator in dancing competitions and always encouraged the learners. She took part in the score competitions here for St. Joseph's Club. Mary and Maurice were a great team. They complemented one another. And with their daughters Stephanie and Edel and son Conor, they made up a happy and a close-knit family. In later years, her dog, Biscuit, became an important member of the family. One of her great joys during her illness in hospital was to get a visit from Biscuit. You could say that Mary liked to keep a low profile. She didn't really like the limelight, yet she liked to travel and to go out to dancing sessions all over this country and America. She enjoyed the set dancing most of all, but was interested in all kinds of dancing, including ballroom dancing and jiving. In recent years, when Strictly was on TV, Mary was not to be disturbed. She adjudicated at an All-Ireland jiving competition in Claremorris some years ago. Mary worked for many years in Omagh in the bank, travelled every day from Ederney to Omagh, but she continued with her dancing mostly at the weekends. And during the summer months, she often went to the Willie Clancy Summer School in County Clare. On many occasions, she travelled to America with her two girls, who are now in the McNamee School of Dancing, to the World Championships, even bringing home some medals. Mary made many friends in the dancing world. Mary made everybody who came to her home welcome. That had been the McGuire tradition in Duroc, where neighbours came together to ceilidh in each other's houses. That tradition went on for many years. I know a man from Donegal. He told me recently that when he was in this area, he used to love to call at Maurice McGrath's on his way home, for he was sure of getting a good meal there. I asked him, did Maurice cook the meal? He said to me, you must be joking. Maurice couldn't boil an egg. But his wife Mary, he says, was the best cook in Ireland. Not only was Mary a good cook, she was a great homemaker, a loving and kind person, always with a smile. Everybody, as we say, got a warm welcome in her home. There was always tea and whatever food you would like. She continued that tradition of hospitality that has kept our communities together for generations and given the Irish the reputation for being the most hospitable people in the whole world. Mary was also a woman with strong principles. She respected everybody and made no distinctions. Everybody was equal in her eyes. When you met Mary out, as I did many times, either here or in Donegal or wherever, she was the same Mary, warm and friendly and caring, always asking about everyone. During her serious illness, Mary showed amazing courage and dignity that I thought must have come from her strong faith. In these last days and weeks of her life, she was very much at peace and reconciled. Mary died peacefully on Friday afternoon in the city hospital, Belfast. She is now gone to her true home to be with God and the saints and the angels and the deceased family members. She bore her illness with great courage and fortitude. And that helped Maurice, Stephanie and Conor and Edel. She loved them with love beyond all telling and helped them as best she could to be reconciled to her departing, knowing that someday they would be together again. Maurice, Stephanie, Dell, and Conor were truly blessed to have Mary as their mother, friend, well, as Maurice's wife, mother, friend, and advisor, who encouraged them to follow their dreams. Today, we give thanks to God for her life of goodness and kindness, and the happiness and love that she brought to her family and friends. We were all blessed to have known Mary McGrath. It all started at an Irish music session in Pettigo. As we share the Eucharist today, we thank God for Mary's life of sharing and caring, of kindness and hospitality. She has left a wonderful legacy and an example of how to enjoy life and how to contribute to the happiness of others without any fuss or fanfare. Her earthly tent is now folded. She has joined the Lord of the dance, where there's no more suffering, only freedom and joy. Eriash J. Guru Ahanam Jilish. Now I invite you to stand and I invite those reading the prayers to please come forward. The prayers. Yeah. Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through him. Let us pray with confidence through him who shared our earthly exile so as to bring us to our heavenly home.
We pray in thanksgiving for all the blessing that came to so many people through the life of Mary. May she now receive the fullness of God's blessing in eternity. Lord, hear us. We pray for all who are suffering with ill health at this time. May they experience the loving kindness of the Lord in and through all who journey with them. Lord, hear us. May the God of all consolation be with all who are in sorrow and mourning the loss of Mary. May he give Maurice,
Conor, Stephanie, Edel, and Seamus the courage and strength to live through this time of suffering which has been laid upon them, and give them a deep peace which only He can give. Lord, hear us. We pray for all deceased relatives and friends. May the Lord bring them into the light of His presence and give them a share in His glory. Lord, hear us. We pray for the doctors, nurses, and staff who cared for Mary during her illness. May God give them strength to continue their work. Lord, hear us.
Father, you made us for yourself, and our hearts will never rest until they rest in you. Grant that amid the uncertainties of this changing world, our hearts may be set on our eternal home, where true joys are to be found. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated now. The gifts will now be brought to the altar. Pray, sisters, brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, Lord, so that your departed servant Mary may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Lawrence, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Mary, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. I'd like to remember today also Frances McGee of New Street, wife of Dennis McGee, who died yesterday. And also Francis Collins, who died in Australia. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Let us pray the prayer that unites all Christians. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Mary may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before the final prayers, a word of thanks to Father Frank, the parish priest, for all his help with the liturgy today, and for his attention to Maurice and the family these last days. Thank Eileen, the sacristan. I'd like to thank the undertakers, Jim and Brendan, and special word of thanks to the beautiful singing and playing of Sinead Moncrief and Eamon Donnelly. Thank all who helped with the readings, Eucharistic minister, and all who helped in any way with this liturgy today. I think we all feel comforted and strengthened by being here, by receiving Holy Communion, by hearing God's reassuring words. So we go away at peace and thanking God. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Just to say that family would prefer if there were no shaking hands at the end. I understand that you are free to come up, set it, and just show your sympathy without shaking hands. Thank you. The COVID is still around, I can tell you. Before we go, our supply stand now. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant to her, Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Mary in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Mary in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Mary, and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we're with you and with our sister forever. Amen. You may be seated now, please. There are refreshments in the club rooms after the burial. Everybody's welcome. Okay. can switch on the mic. The Lord be with you. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Mary, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Mary again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will now disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.